the 69th edition of the Grey's Thurrock Talking Newspaper. It's Tuesday, the 30th of October, 2012. I am John, your link, and around the table are your readers.
Jeff.
Mike.
Julia.
And John is doing the recording. Sunrise and sunset times for Wednesday, the 7th of November.
I've got a bit of a history when I was working of doing voluntary work. I was working in London, and we had an office in the East End, and I used to volunteer at Swanley School, which was a 95% Muslim community. And the kids there used to go home, and nobody in the house spoke English apart from them. So I got involved with reading skills, mentoring, interview techniques, and so on. And then when I retired in 2009, I didn't really fancy trekking back up to London all the time, so I looked around for something local. And I came across this, which was good for me, because my mother actually had glaucoma, which she contracted quite late in life. I mean, she lived till she was 90. But she contracted it quite late in life, and she used to have the Talking Newspaper, which at that time was on the old cassette tape. And when I used to go and see her, she was very often listening to local news, and quite often I had to sit quietly until it was all finished. So she obviously got quite a lot of fun from that, and I thought it was nice to carry it on.
Well, I also spend a couple of days a month delivering library books to the housebound, and a number of those, it's no coincidence, because they're housebound, some of them have visual impairment, and so I get to meet a number of people who also use the Talking Newspaper, and I know they're very, very pleased with it. And it's surprising, although it seems very mundane just reading things from the Gazette, they're happy to keep in touch with what's going on locally.
Been going since 1974. I joined the late 70s, so I'm one of the old guard, definitely. Things are running pretty smoothly. I suppose getting more blind and partially sighted people to join us, the last time there were statistics on this, I think something like a half to perhaps two-thirds of people in Thurrock who could be qualified to join us did not. I don't know if that still applies nowadays, but I've no doubt there are quite a few people out there who could join us. If they'd like to let us know, we'll visit them and assess them, and they're quite welcome to join us.
I think it's vital, because it's a link, and whilst it would be nice if they all had a friend or a relative who could sit down and read the paper to them, I think in the modern world that just doesn't happen to any degree. So it's nice that there's some people around who can actually do this in their own time voluntarily and get it out there, so they can still keep in touch with what's going on in their local community. And many of them have lived in Grays and Thurrock all their life, so I think it's absolutely vital.
Yes, we are always looking for volunteers. We have two time periods where volunteers are welcome. Tuesday nights, as you've just done, and Wednesday mornings. In the Wednesday mornings, they put the recordings onto USB sticks for sending off to blind people. You can phone me at home on 01375 373 611, or you can go to tnf.org.uk, and that's an umbrella organisation for the whole country, and you'll find us on the website.
I think with a bit of promotion we could be back up there again, if we can find a way of getting it out there, because I think I'm sure there's more people who are not yet aware that this exists.
So from all of us here, goodbye until next week.